and we're going to have a little competition on this. We call this a ladder drill. So you would have each kid start out here with a putt and count their scores. Okay, so he has a one. Now he comes back here and he's going to go from here to try to get it in the bucket. All right, he missed. Okay, so that's two strokes. Three strokes, that's his total so far. Then he goes back to the pitch and back here. Now he's going to try to get it in the hole. Yes! So that would be a hole in one. So now he's got, you're going to keep adding up the totals, and then ultimately he's going to go back to the full swing, throw it, and however many strokes it takes him to get into the hole, that's his score. So each kid will do that. And then we'll try to determine, you know, who's the winner. Maybe there's a tie, then they have to have a playoff. But you can see, this game in itself is really going to be fun for the kids to compete. And as they're doing this, they're learning as they're playing. And that's the whole concept.
This is called the line drill. Now, what you're going to do is have each kid going to pair up two against two. And they stand about 4 or 5 feet away. And then the kids are going to swing back and forth. Throw it to try to get it the closest to the line. So each kid will throw it. Then you have to measure. Okay, he won. So then he stands over, the other kid waits. Then you go through each group. Closest to the line, what that's doing is teaching distance awareness. Then you go back a little bit farther and you throw it. And you could do this at different distances, but basically then you'll have the winners will play off, and then you'll have a winner ultimately for the contest. So it's called just the line drill. It's a fun contest that the kids could play, and maybe the first one that wins twice is the winner. So this is a circle drill for accuracy. So you can either do this individually by having kids throw the ball, try to get it in, then they have to move back. You might have markers back here, then they throw it again. If they get it in, then they move back, and maybe you have five sets of markers going on back. And the kids try to go to the farthest marker that they can throw it in and keep it into the circle. Now, you can either say the ball needs to be in the circle, or sometimes if you want to make it real easy for the kids, just if the ribbon touches the rope, that's called in the circle. So we use that as another way to play this. But anyway, that's another great one you can do. You can do this either individually to see how far back, mark it where the longest one is that they got in, and then that's the winner. Or you could even do teams on this, like we did the line drill. Okay, this is called mulligans because you get a second chance after they play the first game. Then you get a chance to come back up and do it again. Now what you're going to do here is you're going to take the rope and make it into two lines, and you can determine how far apart. And here I've got it about 4 feet apart. The idea behind this is you have three or four kids line up in a row opposite this first marker. So they're all about this far. And then they're gonna have their ball in their hand, and you go one, two, three, and they all throw it and try to get it in between the lines. Then if someone misses, they have to sit down, and they're gonna get a second chance. They're gonna get a mulligan the next time around. Then you just proceed back, a little farther back, you line them up, and then you have them go one, two, three, and then they try to get it inside the rope again, and then you weed out those that are not in there, and then they go back. And you can go ahead and put other markers as far back as you want, but what this is, it's just a really fun game. You'll have a winner, and then everybody comes back out, and then you do it again, so everybody gets a second chance. That's why we call it the mulligan drill. So you can see how easy this is to set up, and what this is doing is really helping him to feel the distance awareness of swinging the air golf flyer, and ultimately all these feelings are going to transfer over to real golf. So this is called long shot, or the long drive. Now the kids have may seen this on TV where they have a long drive, you know, championship with golf. And so what we've done is we've got a grid out there, and they're going to stand between the tee off area here, swing the ball back and forth, and we'll give each one of them like 4 shots or 5 shots. And what they have to do is they have to throw it as far as they can and keep it within the boundaries. If they go over a boundary, that's out of bounds. Then what you simply do is then you would take a marker
and put it out where those balls, where the longest one goes, inside the grid, and then have every kid come up, take their swing, throw it out there, and then the longest drive wins. So this is another really easy, fun one, but then again, now it's really teaching that full body wind up and unwind to give them that ultimate feeling. And then the next step is going to be getting them with have two hands in front of their body like real golf for them to go out and play. So you can set, you still have the course set up, but what I'm gonna add is a little fun thing. What I've done is I've taken three hula hoops and stacked them out there different distances between me and the hole. So the kid does, like on the second hole, he's got to throw it over and try to get it into the hula hoop. If he misses, then he has to throw it in the hoop, and then he has to go to the next hoop, and then to the following one, and then it's kind of almost like golf, air golf croquet. To finish the hole out, he's got to keep the number of strokes that it takes him to get to the hoop, to get to the hoop, the hoop, and then ultimately into the bucket. So this can be played as either as an individual, or I wanted to show you what's called alternate shot. And that's where you would divide up into two or three on a team. The first player throws the ball wherever it ends up, then the second player on the team has to throw the ball for the next shot. If there's just two, then the original player throws the next one. So they're alternating swinging until the ball gets in the hole. You can have three on a team or four on a team, but they all are part of a team and they each have a number, one through four, one through two, and then they alternate all the way around. So you can create a little team competition this way.